Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding Even As Lahore Limps to Normalcy, written by Raza Rumi. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2. Plus this is important for sociology optional students. Now what is this editorial about? This editorial is about the intolerance that the Pakistan is spewing on the Christians. This editorial is also about religious formalism and political formalism. Now, in order to understand this editorial, first of all, we need to understand the concept of formalism. Now, what is meant by formalism? Now, formalism means when there is a wedge. Formalism means when there is a gap. Formalism means when there is a hiatus. Formalism means when there is a chasm between the ideals and our aspirations. Now, when it comes to the ideals of the Indian Constitution, the ideals are republican form of government. Ideals are like socialistic form of government. Ideals are like secular form of government and democratic form of government. Now all these ideals, they actually become the mean to achieve the end. Now what end the India is looking for? Now the ends like justice, the ends like equality, ends like fraternity, ends like freedom, ends like development. Now these are the aspirations of India, and the ideals are like republican form of government, democracy, socialism and secularism. Now when it comes to the religious formalism and the political formalism, there is always a gap between what we are talking in theoretical sense and what actually exists in reality. Now in case of Pakistan, there is a big chasm in what they talk about in theory and what is actually in existence in the practical levels of Pakistan. Now when we understand the phenomena of Pakistan, when we understand what Pakistan wants, when we understand what is written theoretically in the constitution, in the preamble of Pakistan, the ideals that come to fore, they are actually very high ideals. Now, let me read the preamble of Pakistan. Now, this thing will really make the stuff clear that what Pakistan actually desires for. Now, the preamble of Pakistan goes like this: whereas sovereignty over the entire universe belongs to Almighty Allah alone. Now, the basic first line of the preamble says that Allah is sovereign for the entire universe, and the authority to be exercised by the people of Pakistan within the limits prescribed by him is a sacred trust. Now the second line of the preamble says that it is as per the desire of the Allah authority has been conferred onto the people of Pakistan to run their governance. And whereas it is will of the people of Pakistan to establish an order. Now it is the people of the Pakistan who will be establishing an order, wherein the state shall exercise its powers and authority through the chosen representatives of the people. Now it is explicitly mentioned in the preamble of the Pakistan that whatsoever government they will be choosing, it will be elected by the people. It is the representatives of the people who will be ruling the country, who will be governing the country. The governance structure will be carried by the representatives of the people. Now, democracy, the ideal of democracy that exists in India is also mentioned in the preamble of Pakistan. Then next line, wherein the principles of democracy, freedom, equality, tolerance, and social justice as enunciated by Islam shall be fully observed. Now the preamble states that the Islam wants that the democracy should be established, Islam wants the freedom, equality should be established, Islam wants tolerance should be established, Islam wants social justice should be there. Now, this is an ideal of Islam. This is an ideal that the Pakistan wants to achieve. Now the next is, wherein the Muslims shall be enabled to order their lives in the individual and collective spheres in accordance with the teachings and requirements of Islam as set out in the Holy Quran and Sunnah. Now whatever higher ideals are mentioned in Quran and Sunnah, those will be followed in the governance process of Pakistan. Then last, and the most important thing of the preamble of the Pakistan, it states that wherein adequate provision shall be made for the minorities freely to profess and practice their religions and develop their cultures. Now, the preamble explicitly states that the Pakistan's constitution, Pakistan's governance structure will provide sufficient freedom, will provide sufficient autonomy to the minority section to explicit their religious beliefs, their religious ideals, to profess and to practice their religion. And a sufficient space would also be given to the minority section so that they can enjoy their culture. Do hereby, through our representatives in the National Assembly, adopt, enact, and give to ourselves this constitution. Now this is what Pakistan's constitution wants. This is what the preamble explicits about the Pakistan. But what is actually existing in Pakistan is a lot of political and religious formalism. Now why do this thing of formalism incept? Why the inception of formalism takes place? Why the growth of formalism takes place? It takes place because the religion, the way it is practiced through the prism of politics. It is not practiced through the prism of spirituality. It is not practiced through the prism which can help emancipate the soul, which can help to reinvigorate the soul. It is practiced for the ulterior motives. It is practiced to help one grow in politics. Now, what needs to be done in order to remove this formalism? How can we protect the minorities? Now, the minority protection, minority welfare, minority development, cohesion of the society, fraternity of the society can take place, can exist if we remove this domain of religion from the social life. If we confine this religion to our own self, if we not try to dominate our religion over others, if we not try to hegemonize our religion over others, because it is the religious ascendancy which is causing the problem, which is leading to bigger troubles. It is not the spiritual upliftment. So the way the religion is being practiced, it is practiced in a wrong manner. Had the religion been practiced in the right manner, the religion would have given the message of humanity and humanism to the world, not the message of wars and strife and grief. So what the world has actually got out of the religion, the way it is practiced, Religion has given the fault lines, but the purpose of the religion was to remove all the fault lines, to realize the Almighty, to go in for the enrichment of the self, to develop the souls, to keep your conscience at ease by doing the right. Now, this was the purpose of the religion. Now, the way it is being practiced, we are putting ourselves at unease. There is lesser compatibility between our inner ease and the conscience and our actions. Our actions are troubling our inner ease. Our actions are troubling our inner peace. So, what the world wants? The world wants religious emancipation. Now, in the 18th and the 19th century, what we have seen was the transformation of the religion, transformation of the decadent social practices. We have seen how the sati was removed. We have seen how the child marriage was removed. We have seen how the purdah system was removed. Now, all these things were getting some kind of sanctification by the religion. Now, religion was acting as a denominator to all these decadent practices. But now, religion is acting as a denominator to terrorism. So what we need is reformation. What we need is renaissance in religion. What we need is transformation in religion. What we need is the revival of religion. What we need is the revival of the truth. What we need is the revival of the peace. And how can that come? We actually, the time zone, the time span currently we are in, we are actually lacking the real world emancipators. We are lacking the real religious leaders. Now, why we are lacking in the personalities, the philosophers, why we are not having, why our age is not having Aristotle, why our age is not having Plato, why our age is not having Gandhi, why we are missing with all these personalities? Now, we are missing because the entire religious space, entire economic space, entire political space is guided by the power of money. It's the money that is deciding everything. So before we remove religion as the denominator, we will also require to remove money, capitalism, the market forces as a denominator from the cultural practices. Only then we will be able to truly transform what all is in existence. Because what is in existence is troubling the minorities, is troubling the diversity of the mankind. So this was all for the tutorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIS Mentors. You can contact me at 845-940-000 in case you're interested in buying the video class in entire Civil Services Preparation. And in order to avail the information of the class that we're offering, please visit our websites eiasmentors.com and brainiki.com. And in case you've liked this video, do click on the like button, do share and comment on this video. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.